Hi, this is a photograph I took this morning on the weekly bike ride along the River Wandle. This is our local beauty spot, such as it is. You can see factories around. It was a very industrialised river in the 19th century. It's not the Amazon, far from it. But what was attractive was the mist rising from the river. So we're going to have a go at it, but I'm not going to put the factories in. I'm going to just invent a background for that. But that tree looks very interesting. I'll do some sort of version of it. And let's see how we go. So I'll put that to one side. Before I forget, I'll just come up to that. And that'll do, I think. So I'll put that where I can see it. If you see me leaning across, you'll know it's because I'm refreshing the screen. Just a bit more. Yeah, beautiful day today. Blue skies, very, very cold this morning. It was about 1 degree when we set out and about 4 degrees when we came back. But our average age of the five of us is about 70. So we don't go fast. We try not to crash into each other. Right, here's my palette. It's a white display tray, lemon yellow, filthy dirty. Let's give it a bit of a clean. I've ordered a load more paint, so I'm going to use as much of this lemon yellow as I can. I might even try to carve it up. I'm going to try using cadmium yellow instead of the lemon yellow and see what happens. I've got some artist quality cadmium yellow, but it's rather stronger and overpowering than the rest of the colours. So we've got lemon yellow, raw sienna, alizarin crimson, light red, ultramarine, burnt umber, Payne's grey, burnt sienna, which is a colour I use probably more than any other. I'll give it a bit of a spray just to soften the paint. Just give it a start. I'm not going to do any drawing. I'm just going to go straight in with a background sky and so on. Now, wet in wet watercolour. Oh, big brush watercolour using the 45mm wide, 1¾ hake, Ron Ranson hake. There we are, Ron Ranson, the large Ron Ranson hake. By Pro Art, easy to get hold of. They're so popular now because of Ron Ranson, who put us all onto this about 25 years ago. A swig of tea. In the summer, you can't see all the factories and housing estates. But as I've mentioned many times before, this river supported many mills over its 16-mile meander to the Thames. But is now a lovely fishing river, fly fishing, plenty of carp. But unfortunately, there are lots of fishermen too. And they don't always put the catch back for other people to catch. Right, okay, so I'm going to put some raw sienna all the way over all of this. Right, here we go. So just into the water, although the water is reflecting blue. So I have to put some blue sky in. But I want to... I think the misty bit I'm going to have to go over with a bit of white. I don't know, I'm thinking of gouache when this is dry, or a wash of acrylic, white acrylic with a touch of blue in, but we'll see. So let's go into the ultramarine. Now my ultramarine is quite moist because I loaded up the other day. So let's just... But I'll put the blue in at the bottom rather than in the middle, because that's where we're going to put the mist. A little bit over here. I think that'll do. I'll put a bit of red in, I think. But I don't want too much here because I'm going to put that tree in. So let's just try a bit of... just to get a bit of life. Now that's going to be a nice bit of foreground there. Okay, now my bit of cloth is a bit thin for this, so let's get a larger piece. It's an old face flannel, I think. Right, you'll notice that your paint will dry much nicer than you put it on, so you have to be aware of that. I'm going to dry this, so headphones off. Let's just take a bit off the bottom of that. Right, it's not so dry that it's dry on the inside of the paper, it's just the surface dry. Right, okay, now we'll put a bit of background in. So let's well, let's go a bit mad with this background. A bit of green in there. Okay, that'll do. Now we've got the bank. Let's put a bit more warm in that foreground here, with this bit of distance, I see. Alright, let's lift out loads of these trees here. Probably doing this a bit quick because it will fill in to a certain extent. But right now we're getting this sort of misty bank. Coming down to the foreground. So this is the bank, so we'll just make this warmer as we come into the foreground. And then that will do for that. Just look for some mini dark areas. One there. And probably just a bit there. Bit of sienna. Right, so I can do that with a plastic card, just show some reeds, just bramble. From where I'm sitting here to there, it's probably about 4 inches on here, but it's probably about 50 yards, 50, 60 yards, maybe. I will put in a bit of this bank here. The river goes up and round there, so we'll just and the bank comes sort of down off the page a little bit. I'll briefly show you another picture I took, which I'm going to do in acrylic. And then we come down here and we've got loads of Okay, so good rich darks in this foreground here. This is all in sort of shadow. All one brush. Darker. Just a melange of darks in here. Right. I need to bring that back round that way a bit off, so I'm just going to do that round here a little bit. Right, okay, so let's just get in some now, as usual, I overdo this, but I want to go into that tree now. But before I do that, I want to just lift out a little bit of that going up here for this tree. So I'm going to draw it off first, quickly, so headphones off. I should have filled that in there, so I'm going to do that now. So I want a bright sort of lemon yellowy colour in here because the light is catching. And a bit of sienna in there, I think, just to warm it up. Then I'll dry it. Right, okay. With some clean tissue, I'll clean the brush, a nice clean brush, and right, nice just take the water out of the brush a little bit. So let's I'm not copying the tree, I'm just using it as a model. Let's just get some of these coming on here. I will put some shadow back on these. Some of this up here, get that off there. Okay, that's got a little bit awry there. We just thicken that up a little bit. Using the hake, it's a bit hit and miss. Right, okay, now we'll go in with the it's sort of a greeny colour now, so yellow ochre or burnt sienna with a bit of lemon yellow, so and the shadow obviously on the top. I'll use the rigger on some of this, but I want to just to get this a little bit thicker. And if we've touched just a little edge of that there with a bit of clean water, that will fill in, hopefully will lighten, and then we've got some dark. So let's use some burnt sienna and a bit of Payne's grey, a bit of palette grey really. Get that light on further up there. Now back to the yellowy. So lemon yellow and a bit of sienna. Let's just get that in there. Right, let's get some darks in there now. I'll use a bit of Payne's grey. The sun's coming from the right. Oops. My hand's a little bit shaky on it. Remember, this will dry lighter. Maybe I've just overdone that a little bit. Thicken that up, otherwise my taper is sort of gone. Need a cloth when you're doing this to take the excess moisture off the hake, otherwise you'll be endlessly frustrated. Thank you. Okay, that's as good as I'm going to get that. Put a bit of rigger work in there, I think, just to show a lot of twigs without any. I'll probably stipple a few leaves on it. You can't put everything in, don't even try. I don't know which tree this is, it should be a willow, because it's on the edge of the water, it goes over the water, but you never know. There are lots of willows on the Wandle, and they get huge, and then they break. They sort of destroy themselves, they've got a death wish. Well, a little bit of fussiness around here. Let that other side dry off a little bit. Bit of blue. Now I'm going to dry this off, and I'm going to dry this off now, and we'll have a go with the acrylics and see what we can make of that. So, to put a bit of misty stuff in. So this won't strictly be a watercolour, it'll be a mixed media, but I've got my palette here. Right, I'll clean this. This my Masterson Stay Wet palette, Stay Dirty palette. Right, I'll just clean the centre of that. We don't want it solid with palette grey. So, Saturday we had acrylic, yesterday we had oil, today we've got watercolour. Right, I'm going to use one of my soft brushes, well, I mean the varnish brushes, but the softer of the three. So plenty of water on there, and a bit of white, and a bit of ultramarine. but just a bit of ultramarine. I don't know how this is going to work, but don't know if this is going to work. Excuse me. Right, I'm going to dry this off again because I hope that this is going to give a slightly sealed coat because it's acrylic. Right, let's go back to it now. Well, I'm not sure if that's really working, but I'll dry it. Right, well that's as good as I'm going to get in watercolour anyway. With acrylic it'd be much easier. We could go over opaque paint. Right, just dry that off. And now I want to put some rigger work back on the top of this, over the mist or in front of, right, with the watercolour, so we don't need those anymore. Clean the brush, watercolours, back with the darker burnt sienna and Payne's grey. Right, now we've got some sticking up here. Right, now I'm going to clean off my brush, dry it off, and we'll dip it in some dippery. Hanging on, twigs, mostly twigs. Oh, saw some lovely daffodil bulbs up this morning in Ravensbury Park. And we just put a bit of dark in there as well. Right, that's about as good as I'm going to do with that. The tree's not too bad. Right, let's put it in a mount and we'll have a look and see how bad it is. Oh, do you ever? I took a picture out of a frame yesterday. It was the one. It was the dusk over an English moor that I did last week. And it dried a little bit dull, so I took it out of its frame. And when I put it back, my finger just caught the edge of the glass. And you couldn't get... Can you see that? There we are. Right on the tip, right where you touch. Sure, not sore. See what that is. Oh, that's blue and blue, plenty of blue in there. Well, it's all right as a demo, but it won't win any prizes, I think. But I just tried to, it was just that misty. I was going to show, I'll show you the what we've just tried to do. I've come out and I just want to see if I can find. There's another one I did. There we are. Taken from the boardwalk, the new boardwalk in Mordenhall Park. This is further on in the Wandle towards Merton Abbey Mill, which still works. But it's a lovely picture. My friend said, well, there's no colour in it, but there is. Look, there's all this lovely burnt sienna. You can have some fun with that in acrylic. I can do that in acrylic. That's probably my next painting. Right, let's have a look at this in the mount then. Well, after chores tomorrow, which no doubt I'll have to do, we can get back to painting. Let's get that straight. Sorry about all the movement. Well, we are. That's not too bad, is it? I think that's gone a bit thick for that. But I'm not going to do any more to that. It's what it is. It's not too bad. Let me know what you think. It's bound to get a few unlikes. But any comments, anything you want to know, just leave it on the video YouTube. Thanks for watching. See you soon. Bye-bye.